Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. All praises belong to Allah, the Lord of the worlds. We beseech him to shower his blessings on the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his household, his companion, and the Muslim Ummah. Eid Mubarak. Taqabbalallahu minna wa minkum. May Allah accept all our ibadat in the past Ramadan and bless us with our heart desires that will be beneficial to us in both worlds. How are you, my students? How are your parents? May Allah continue to keep us safe. May Allah wipe off the pandemic sooner than we expect for us to meet again in our normal school setting. It's another English class on CTY Model College, Ibadan, Oyo State e-learning portal. And today, we are looking at the topic grammar, some noun clauses. Grammar, some noun clauses. What is a clause? By the end of this lesson, we hope to achieve what a clause is, the types of clauses that we have, and what is a noun clause, how to identify a noun clause, and look at some examples of noun clauses. What is a clause? A clause is a group of words that contains a subject and a predicate. A clause is a group of words that contains a subject and a predicate. We know that a subject in English studies is the performer of the action, and a predicate is a part of a sentence or clause that contains a verb and it states something about the subject. It tells us something about the subject. A clause that can stand on its own, when you read it, you get a complete meaning. That clause is known as a main clause or independent clause. A clause that can stand on its own and give complete meaning is known as a main clause or independent clause. A clause that depends on another clause to give complete meaning. If you read it, you cannot decipher what you have read. You ask, what does this mean? What is it saying? Then that clause is known as a dependent clause or a subordinate clause. A clause that depends on another clause to give complete meaning is known as a dependent clause or a subordinate clause. What is a noun clause? A noun clause is a subordinate clause that does the work of a noun in a sentence. A noun clause is a subordinate clause that does the work of a noun in a sentence. So how do we know that this is a noun clause? To identify a noun clause, we need to find out what the subject knows. To identify a noun clause, we need to find out what the subject knows. We question it. She heard what? She heard what? Answer, a distant toad was what she heard. A distant toad was what she heard. This is a noun clause. Therefore, a noun clause can be identified by asking a what or who question in a sentence. A noun clause usually begins with words like that, what, if, whether, how, where, who, whom, whose, why, however, whatever, wherever, whoever, etc. A noun clause, we can identify a noun clause when we see a clause in a sentence and this clause is performing the work of a noun. And it begins with that, what, if, whether, how, where, who, whom, whose, why, however, whatever, wherever, whoever, then we should know that this is a noun clause. Look at the examples. It is obvious that she is absent. That she is absent is obvious. It is obvious that she is absent. That she is absent is obvious. These two sentences mean the same thing. The noun clause can be at the beginning or at the end of a sentence. That she is absent is the subject of this sentence. It's the subject of the verb is. That she is absent is the subject of the verb is. So it's obvious is the predicate of this sentence. What we need is a new duster. What we need is a new duster. A new duster is what we need. These two sentences too mean the same thing. And I told you earlier that this noun clause can be at the beginning or at the end of a sentence. A new duster is what we need. What we need is a new duster. What we need is the subject of the verb is. Let's analyze some sentences on page 142 and 143 of your NUSEC textbook. That's where we have this topic, page 142 and page 143. That it rained is the subject of the verb is, and the predicate is unfortunate. That it rained is unfortunate. That it rained is the subject of the verb is. That she is absent. That she is absent is obvious. That she is absent is the subject of the verb is. That the pendulums moved. That the pendulums moved pleased the teacher. That the pendulums moved is the subject of the verb pleased. So the subject in each sentence is a clause, not a noun. And we call it a noun clause because it is doing the work of a noun. Let's look at more examples. What we need is a new duster. A new duster is what we need. What you have married is a jewel. A jewel is what you have married. What I forgot was my stick. My stick was what I forgot. What we need is the subject. Remember, when it starts with that, what, if, how, where, who, whom, whose, etc., then it's performing the work of a noun, then it's a noun clause. What we need is the subject of the verb is. What we need is a new duster. What you have married is a jewel. What I forgot was my stick. What I forgot is the subject of the verb was. So in the sentences that I've just analyzed, the subject is a noun clause beginning with what. And the verb is a form of be, that is, was, followed by a noun, new duster. We can change the A sentences to B sentences by making the subject and the complement change places. The predicate can be at the beginning and the subject can be at the end, vice versa. But if the verb is followed by an adjective instead of a noun, we cannot have a B sentence. For example, we cannot have a B sentence for the sentence, what I found was interesting. Interesting is an adjective. So we can't have a B sentence for such a statement. What I found was interesting. So this is the end of the lesson for today. We have looked at what a clause is, the types of clauses that we have. We also learned what a predicate is in a sentence. Then we looked at what a noun clause is and how to identify a noun clause. We also analyzed some sentences. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah wa barakatuh. Your assignment is on the CTY e-learning portal. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah wa barakatuh.